This house appropriated 26, 23 billion. Donors paid, the World Bank, Denmark, USAID. And Mr. Speaker, KEMSA is the largest recipient of USAID fund in the whole continent of Africa from the US government. And I want to challenge the US government. And I want the US ambassador to listen to me. Even if we want to steal our own money, you must take care of the American taxpayers. Because for too long, the donors must, the World Bank must ask for value for their money. The Danish government must ask for it. The US government must not sit down. They have their own investigative agencies. And I'm sure they know the culprits. Mr. Speaker, a company that was formed 2 weeks, 2 weeks when this pandemic broke, it's called Shop and Buy Limited. When I saw Shop and Buy, Mr. Speaker, I thought this is a company that sells, you know, diapers, that sells presents. You know from the name, Shop and, it's called Shop and Buy. And I watched the committee when the CEO of that company came for grilling. So Speaker, that company belongs to a big fish. That guy was just a face of it. I mean, Speaker, there are many. And I want to challenge the president. I want to challenge EACC. I want to challenge the Office of the Director of Criminal Investigation that do not be part and parcel of those who, in my own words, quote unquote, committed genocide against many Kenyans today who are in their graves. Do not be complacent. Bring those people to book. Mr. Speaker, misappropriation of funds in this case has led to death. Corruption has led to the death of many people. Over 1,000 health workers have tested positive. And I want to say it here clearly, Mr. Speaker, if you allow me. The problem that we see in our counties, we are going to challenge the control of budget. The money we have allocated to counties, Mr. Speaker, has gone to waste. The president should not be having a virtual conference with these governors. The president should send his intelligence.
Just 1 minute. 1 minute.
Mr. Speaker, the president should send his intelligence team to all the counties, starting with the Garissa, where there's no even one single ICU bed, Mr. Speaker. All the monies this house allocated and the National Treasury sent to the counties, Mr. Speaker, has gone to people's pockets. The doctors in Garissa were on strike the whole of this week. 3-4 babies have died. Mr. Speaker, we cannot say it again that this corruption, and you know, when I saw Honorable Nikal crying, I was shocked. But he cried because there are many Kenyans who died in their hour of need by their government, and Parliament has allocated resources, but some people pocketed. Mr. Speaker, a crime of this nature cannot wait. It's genocide, Mr. Speaker. Governors must be held responsible. The controller of budget must be held responsible. And committees of this House, the Health Committee, should walk away from its comfort in the boardrooms here. They should go and visit the rural health centers.